hello champions, I'm back with another video. So the topic of today's video is that I'm seeing from a lot of days that after class 12th, there are a lot of interested students who want to get into Merchant Navy, but they don't know is BTech Marine Engineering the best option for them or is BSc Nautical Science the best option for them. They have decided that they are going to do one of the two, but they don't know which is the best decision for them between the two. They don't know how to go about it. So in this video, I'll try to help you guys to make the best decision out of this, because obviously when I was in first year or before first year after my 12th, I tried to find this answer as much as with all my might, and I eventually found my answer for this, and right now I've ended my BTech Marine Engineering. So now I'll try to help you guys out in getting the best career option for you in Merchant Navy. So let's get into it. So now together we are going to try to find out the answer for getting you the best career option in Merchant Navy, right? So I've tried to segregate all of my points in bullets, and I'll try to review them throughout the video, and I'll help you out, and I'll try to explain it to you in the best way possible. Okay, so the first thing is, I'll first of all try to explain you what is going to be your job. So it's BSc Nautical Science and it's BTech Marine Engineering. If you do BTech Marine Engineering, you get into the engine side, you become an engine officer, someone who is dealing with the engine, and the supported machineries, the auxiliary machineries around the engine, right? So if you get into BTech Marine Engineering, what you will be doing is you will be taking care of the machineries, every machinery that is helping in running of the ship, propulsion of the ship. Okay, now that is in a very layman's term, ki jo bhi machinery ship ke chalne mein help karti hai, we are going to maintain that machinery, and we are going to help in transiting the ship from point A to point B, right? Now coming to the deck officers, what is the job of the deck officers? Now the first job of the deck officer is navigation. Now when the ship is going from point A to point B, let's say from India to Australia, what path is the ship going to take? Which ports are it, is it going to stop? See, because we are talking about international waters, we have to understand that there are various countries, there are various boundaries in sea as well. Like there are boundaries in countries on lands, there are also boundaries in the sea. And you have to understand, you have to make path for your ship through various countries, through the waters of various countries. So that is where navigation comes in. You have to take care of the cargo operations. There is various kind of cargo. There can be oil, there can be containers, there can be bulk, maybe coal or something like that on the ship. So you have to take care of that operation, unloading and loading of cargo, taking care of how quick is it going, how much time have you left with, are you left with, what kind of things. That is something that the deck officer takes care of. Apart from that, this is the second thing. Apart from that, all the work that happens on the deck. Now what is the deck? The top platform. The top platform of the ship is known as the deck area. When you visualize a ship in your mind, you might be seeing there's an area at the top where all the cargo is kept. You visualize that the cargo is kept at that place. Actually, that's not true, but you visualize that. So that is the deck area, right? Now all the work that is happening on the deck area, like mooring operations, means when the ship is on the port, you will be pulling in ropes, you'll be trying to tie that ship to the nearest port area, to, you know, I'm not really aware of that because I'm not a BSc guy, I'm not someone, so I cannot tell you in detail, but that is what is the essence of it, right? Now apart from that, these are some of the operations that a BSc Nautical Science or a deck officer has to do. Apart from that, now when you are in oil, when you're working in oil tankers, when you're working in bulk carriers, something that you have to do on a regular basis is also cargo operations. You'll be getting into, that is, you'll be getting inside the cargo holds, you'll be going down, you'll be cleaning them, you'll be inspecting them. All of these things also, these things are also involved as your job as a deck officer. And also as an engine officer, all the tanks that are inside the engine room, like the fuel oil tank, the lube oil tank, all of these tanks, you will, probably once a week or something like that, you'll be inspecting all of that. So this is basically the job that you're going to do in the engine side, as an engine officer, as an engineering officer, and as a deck officer. So that's the first part. The second thing that comes is that where are you going to work? Dekho, the engineering officers, most of the time, almost 70% of the time when you're on board, you are going to be in the engine room. You're going to be working inside the engine room, which is actually below the seawater level inside the ship, right? It's in the aft side, matlab ki piche wale area mein hota hai, ship ke piche wale area mein, at the aft side is the engine room. And there you're going to work throughout the day, almost throughout the day, and then you're going to come go back to your room and all the other stuff. But when we talk about deck officers, most of the time is spent at two places. One is the bridge. Bridge is the place at almost at the top of the ship from where navigation is done. From where the deck officers look and have a watch. They see all the sides. They see the path of the ship and everything. They see the cargo from there itself, right? And the second thing is doing all the job that they have on the deck. These are the two jobs that deck officers generally have. Now, there is a lot of paperwork involved as well when we talk about in the job of both of these guys, both of these type of jobs. We have a lot of paperwork. People don't talk about it. People think that there's only maintenance, but also 40-30% of the job is paperwork. Because again, because you're working in international waters, because you're working for companies that are international companies, so we have to write down and we have to note down everything that is happening on the ship. When we talk about engine side, the propulsion, the oil that is used, the waste that is generated, that has been generated, things that have been, the sewage that has been drained out, everything has to be noted. And when we talk about deck officers, the cargo is coming in, letting out, the trainings that have been done, the cargo inspections that are going on, everything has to be noted there as well. And when you're making parts, the thing that I've just told you, when you're making parts, you have to ask permission from the state authorities. When a ship is going from India to Australia, then let's say Singapore is coming in between. So you'll have to ask permission from Singapore to enter in Singapore's waters. That is just an example that I'm trying to give you. Okay, so this is something, and all of this thing has to be done by deck officers. The paperwork, the permissions, the mails, the companies, the deck work, and all of that. And engine is completely around the engine side. All the machinery maintenance, the paperwork around the machineries, everything. Mails and all of that regarding machineries to the company, all of that has to be done by the engine side, right? So this is basically, as I said, about the job. Now, coming to the shore leaves. The shore leaves that happens for the engine side and for the deck side. Now, what happens with the engine side is that generally when we are on ports, the engine is not working, right? So there are more chances that engineering officers go on port, and you know they can you know land, and they can travel the place, they can travel the port city. There are way more chances for that. But when we talk about BSC guys, when we talk about deck officers, what happens is they don't get as much opportunity because their job is more like 6 on 6 off, right? So you work for 6 hours and then you take rest for 6 hours. So even if you get an opportunity of going, so there is no holidays. There is nothing like holidays because you have to work 6 on and then you have to go off for 6 hours. So even if you're going out, you only get 6 hours at max, and that is also not necessary. So that is one of the major reasons why nautical guys, deck guys don't get an opportunity to go outside, don't get an opportunity for shore leaves and stuff, right? Now, the third thing that I would like to talk about is the scenic view. Now, that is also something important because you a lot of you guys are coming here for traveling and are coming here for looking, getting an opportunity to see beautiful places and all of that from the ship. So in that case also, now what happens is that the engineering side, almost 70-80% of their time, they are in the engine room or they're in the room, right? So only 10 or 15% of the time they are on the deck looking at places and maybe looking at the beautiful view, right? So in that case, they don't get as much opportunity to see all of that scenic view and the sunsets and the sunrise and all of these things, the beautiful Instagram posts that you see of beautiful places and everything. There are less chances that an engineering officer is going to see that. They might see that, but there are less chances comparatively. But when you talk about deck officers, almost 80% of the time, they are on the bridge. So if they are on the bridge, they have way more opportunities of seeing all these sunrises and beautiful sceneries, beautiful countries from the port and everything. They might not get an opportunity to go there, go on ports and everything, but still they have this opportunity of seeing the scenic views and everything, right? Now, the third thing that comes, the fourth thing that comes, that is very, very important, which people don't talk about, actually, is the danger involved. Now, this is something that people don't talk about, that recently what has happened is that there have been a lot of fatalities, a lot of accidents when you talk about depth officers. Why is that? Because when we talk about cargo operations, I just mentioned that deck officers have to go inside cargo spaces for cleaning and everything, right? Now, that is one of the most risky things that you can do on ship. Why? Because the cargo area and the cargo tanks, they may lack oxygen, they may have toxic gases, harmful gases, XYZ, all of these things. So the maximum amount of deaths and fatalities that happen on ship, that is generally because of cargo entry. That is enclosed space entry, right? In engine side is also is injury prone, and you know, injuries happen. It's not like every second day you're seeing injury, every month you're seeing injury, but injuries comparatively are more on the deck side. Now, when we talk about the nature of the job, so from all the things that I've told, you can visualize the work that engine room guys and the deck officers are going to do. Now, the job of the engine officer is more physical. Like maintaining, opening cylinders, opening engine rooms, all the auxiliaries of the engine rooms, the purifiers, the fuel oil pumps, and all of these things, the engine cylinders and all of that, right? But when you talk about the deck officers, now what their job is going to be is proper navigation and proper cargo operations, right? The only time that most of the time when they're going to do physical work is on the deck. That may be around painting and stuff and shipping and stuff, that may be around cargo, enclosed space entry and things like that. But most of their job is going to be on the bridge. They are going to navigate, they are going to navigate the ship, they are going to do all that paperwork that is required for mapping the direction of the ship when it's going from India to Australia, as I said, the example of Singapore that I gave, all of that, understanding that which countries do you need to take permission from before entering their waters and all of that. So all of this work comes into the deck officer side. So that is more of a mental job, right? When you talk about. So you can say that the mental stress part is more in deck officer side, and the physical stress part is comparatively more in the engine side, right? So it's completely depends upon you. What are you looking for and everything. So that was the fifth point that according to me one should know before entering Merchant Navy. And the last point according to me was of off days. Now when you talk about deck officers and engine officers, again, as I said about the deck officers, the job is 6-on-6-off kind of job, right? So you'll be on the bridge for 4-5 hours, 6 hours, and then you'll be again in the room for 4-5-6 hours, right? And this thing is going to continue every day. There are no Sundays, Mondays, nothing. It's just hours that you have to go at 4 o'clock in the morning, and you have to come back at 8 o'clock in the morning. You have to go at 6 o'clock in the evening and come back at 10 o'clock at the night. So things like that. It's completely time based. It's nothing like Sunday go off, chutti. So that is not there. But when you talk about engine side, the good thing is that once you become an officer, Sundays are off comparatively. So the amount of work that you'll have on Sundays is comparatively very less. Like on every day, if you're working like 8 hours, 10 hours, or maybe 11 hours if you're a very junior officer or something like that, or 12 hours or something. If you're a junior officer, that can be a possibility that you're working for 11 hours, 12 hours, and be prepared for it. But yeah, if there is a Sunday, then comparatively your job is not going to be for 11 hours, 12 hours. It's going to be comparatively less. So you'll get that off day to, you know, buckle up things and come back and become lively again for the next week. So that is something that is also there in the inside. So these were basically some of the things that I want to share with you as far as BSc and BTech Marine Engineering is concerned. And I'm sure a lot of these points might not be familiar to you guys. And yeah, so that is what I wanted to share with you. And I hope that you guys might have liked the content. And if you like the content, you can like the channel and you can subscribe the channel, of course. And so that's it from my side. Until then, remain master.